everyone, and welcome to my channel. My name is Shannon. Today I'm here to do my 32 week pregnancy update. So I'm currently 32 weeks and 2 days pregnant today, and I am pregnant for the second time, and this time we are having a little boy. So this past Wednesday I ended up going for a doctor's appointment because I have to go every 2 weeks now that I'm in my third trimester. So this week, my weight pretty much stayed the same. I would say I gained about a half a pound to a pound, and that's great for this time in your pregnancy. I think as you get closer to the end, they kind of anticipate you to gain about like a pound a week, and if I gain a pound each week now until I deliver, that means I'll probably be maybe a few pounds lighter than when I was pregnant the first time. So I'm totally right on track, almost identical with when I was pregnant the first time with my daughter. So at my doctor's appointment, they had a lactation consultant come in and kind of go over how the hospital handles breastfeeding and skin-to-skin contact and things like that. It was really informational for me because I didn't have anyone, I guess, specifically talk to me ahead of time. I didn't take any classes or anything like that, so it was kind of reassuring to know that if I had any questions beforehand, even though this is my second time around, that there would be someone I could specifically talk to and that they would be in the hospital. They're also in the doctor's office and things like that, so that was definitely very helpful. I also saw a midwife this appointment, and she had a student midwife with her, so they just kind of went over the fundamentals again. You know, they went over my blood pressure, they measured my belly, and the update with my last doctor's appointment, they said I was measuring ahead, and I don't know if it's this time because I had the student midwife or what. She said I was measuring right on track. Things may have just evened out this past week, or it's just a discrepancy on how the doctor measured versus how the student midwife measured. But either way, it's completely normal and everything seems to be great. Baby boy has definitely picked up moving this past week. It has been insane. It's to the point where it's not like you just notice it. It's like your stomach gets kind of distorted a little bit, which, I mean, it's kind of creepy to some people, but I think when you're pregnant, it's kind of reassuring to have them move so much. I'm definitely starting to feel a lot more movement at the top of my belly and not so much down low. I do still get a couple kicks or punches to the bladder every now and again, but I definitely think he's moving around in there and trying to, you know, get oriented with his head down and everything else kind of up. That doesn't mean that he's not flipping and rolling during these next few weeks and then he's just stuck in that position, but I definitely think he's moving in the right direction. The other thing that they went over at my doctor's appointment was obviously what is our plan for birth control. I don't know how many of you are following along with my updates, but I currently have a daughter who is 15 months old, and she'll be about 17 months old by the time baby boy is here. Obviously, the doctors usually want you to space your kids out, I want to say at least 2 years, and that just might be their preference, but my husband and I definitely wanted our kids close together, and we're still not sure whether, you know, we'll only have 2 kids or whether we do actually want to have a third child. So she asked what precautions we're going to take because things obviously fell right in line for us to get pregnant right away again. And I don't know how most people feel, but since I am going to be breastfeeding again, I don't want to take any medications or anything like that. I know they have ones that are safe for you to take while you're on breastfeeding. She told me that you really shouldn't rely on breastfeeding as a form of birth control after the first 3 months, just due to the frequency, like how less frequent they eat. But for my husband and I, breastfeeding was 100% a form of birth control for us. We didn't have any problems with it being a form of birth control until I actually started weaning. And that was when I weaned from the pump. So I want to say I was down to at least one, maybe two pumps a day. And the problem with that is obviously you don't know when you're going to ovulate. And so we were just kind of, you know, taking it as it was. And if we got pregnant, that's great. If we didn't, it wasn't a big deal and we'd have something, you know, kind of track and be aware of. So this next time around, I wouldn't say that I want to have all my kids this close together. I would like there to be at least closer to 2 years between a second and third baby. And just kind of give me a break too. It's definitely tough on your body when you're going through pregnancy. So to kind of go through pregnancy and then breastfeed and then at right after you stop, get pregnant again, and your body kind of never had that time to recover. I feel like that would just be exhausting physically for my body to go through that a third time. So we're definitely going to have to take the more natural route of birth control and try and figure out how to do family planning and kind of that whole thing, especially when I start to wean this second baby. So my symptoms this week, I would definitely say the back pain is still there. And I don't really notice it as much per se, because I'm just at the point where I know it's not going to get any better. So I just kind of, you know, deal with it. But the one thing I have noticed is the chafing underneath my bra line has gotten a ton better. So just trying to wear more supportive, like nursing bras and things like that, and using baby powder has helped tremendously. So I would definitely recommend that if you guys are having that kind of problem. Especially with this second pregnancy, my boobs are just not where they used to be. They tend to sit on my belly more, and that just, with the hormones and having hot flashes and things, it's just easier to put baby powder there, and it makes things so much more comfortable. I don't get the itching or anything like that. I have noticed that my hair has been so dry. I could probably go a whole week without washing it and it really wouldn't be terrible. Obviously today I am rocking the mom bun, but that's just out of sheer laziness and not because my hair looks that terrible. I've also noticed that my hands and feet are swelling a little bit. Not anything crazy, but I do think I'll probably take off my rings within the next week or two, just out of precaution. I know that I don't want to end up having to get them cut off or anything like that. So for me, it's just better to not even risk it. I'd rather just take them off and I can put them back on after I deliver and all the swelling from that goes down. The other thing I went over with the doctor is getting a breast pump from my insurance company. Now, since they had already provided a breast pump for my first pregnancy, the doctors weren't really sure if they would provide a second one. My doctor's office is trying to find that out for me, and they're going to submit all the paperwork and go from there. I have about 4 weeks left of work, and so now I'm at the point where I need to start printing off the papers and getting them all filled out for my temporary disability for when I'm out on maternity leave. And at least for the state of New Jersey, you want to make sure you do that ahead of time. I have to physically mail it in, at least that's what I had to do for my daughter, and so that requires me to have a form that I personally fill out, that my doctor fills out, and a form from my employer. And so I need to get all the paperwork to the right people so that there's plenty of time for everything to be filled out. So when I do have my last day of work, I'm able the next day to mail all the paperwork out, and that way there isn't any unnecessary delay. We have started to kind of rearrange our house a little bit. So we did rearrange the living room and things like that this past weekend. And so the chair that's normally in here is now in our basement, so we can have a little area down there for me to watch my daughter if I'm doing laundry, or if my husband just needs to escape and kind of have time to himself. There's a spot for us to kind of have a place for ourselves down in our basement, which is nice. And that's also freed up a lot of room in our living room. So currently we have a rocking chair that's in my daughter's room, and that will go out in the living room. And that way I won't disturb anyone if the baby's being really fussy, and it gives me a really comfortable spot to kind of tend to the baby without having to sit on the couch or use a bunch of pillows to kind of like prop myself up and things like that. So that was great this past weekend. We still have a lot on our checklist, but the things are slowly getting done, and it's crazy to think that I have less than 8 weeks, 9 weeks tops, until this baby is here. And I don't know about any of you second time moms, but definitely the second time around, you kind of get so busy with life and taking care of your little one at home that you sometimes, even though you have a giant belly, you forget that you're pregnant. So for me, this pregnancy has just flown by, and I can't believe that in a month I'll be done work, and in another month or more or less, that we'll have our little baby boy here. And it's really exciting, but it's also really nerve-wracking. I feel like I am so unprepared this time, because like I said, this pregnancy has just gone so fast. And with my daughter, I feel like the weeks just drug on, because I was just so excited to be a mom. And it's not that I'm not excited this time, it's just I feel like I don't have the time to like just sit and ponder how things are gonna be, and you know, things like that. So that's everything for my 32-week pregnancy update, and now I will show you guys my belly.
Okay, so here is my 32-week bump.
Thank you all so much for watching. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below. I do update weekly. I would love to hear from you guys and see where you guys are at in your pregnancy, whether it's your first pregnancy or your second, or whether you're having a little boy or a little girl. And